Good morning, dear students. I am Nita Lakhadevi, madam, from Sri Deshikendra Vidyalaya, Latur. Today, we are going to learn the lesson, The Necklace, Standard 9, Subject English, Unit 1, 1.5, The Necklace. Open your English book, page number 24, The Necklace. At first, we will learn summary of this story. Mathilde was a pretty and charming girl. She was born in a family of clerks. She married to a minor official at the Ministry of Education. She had no rich dresses. She had no jewelry. Once, Mathilde and her husband were invited by the Minister of Education. She had nothing to wear. Her husband gave her 400 francs for a dress. She borrowed some jewelry from her friend, Madame Forestier. They went to the party and enjoyed themselves. Mathilde danced wildly and had fun. They left for home at 4 in the morning. I returned home to realize that the necklace was not on her neck. Mathilde had lost it. This is the summary of part one of the story, The Necklace. Now, we will learn this story line by line. Look at this picture. Look at this picture. This is Mathilde. She was a pretty and charming girl. Now, we will learn the story. Mathilde was a pretty and charming girl. Born as if by an error of fate into a family of clerks. She had no means of becoming known, understood, loved, or be wedded to an aristocrat. And so she let herself be married to a minor official at the Ministry of Education. Look at this picture. This is Mathilda. This is Mathilde. She was a pretty and charming girl. She was born into a family of clerks. She had no means of becoming known, understood, loved, or be wedded to an aristocrat. Hence, she let herself be married to a minor official at the Ministry of Education. Look, next paragraph. I will ask one question, try to give answer of this question. Why was Mathilde married to a minor official? Okay. Mathilde was born into a family of clerks. She had no means of becoming known, understood, loved, or be wedded to an aristocrat. Hence, she let herself be married to a minor official to the Ministry of Education. Next. She dressed plainly because she had never been able to afford anything better. She suffered endlessly, feeling she was entitled to all the luxuries of life. She suffered because of her shabby, poorly furnished house. All these things that another woman of her class would not even have noticed tormented her and made her resentful. She dreamed of a grand palatial mansion with vast rooms and inviting smaller rooms perfumed for afternoon chats with close friends. She dressed plainly because she could not afford. She suffered due to her shabby, poorly furnished house. She dreamed of a grand palatial mansion. Look at this picture. She dreamed of it She dreamed of a grand palatial mansion. Palatial means suitable for a palace. It means Rajmahala Pramani. She dreamed of a grand palatial mansion with vast rooms and inviting smaller rooms. Perfume for afternoon chat with close friends. Next. 8. She had no rich dresses, no jewels, nothing. And these were the only things she loved. She wanted so much to charm, to be envied, to be sought after. She had a rich friend, a former schoolmate at the convent, whom she avoided visiting because afterwards she would weep with regret, despair, and misery. Look at this picture. Mathilde. Mathilde loved rich dresses. She loved jewels also. But she had no rich dresses, no jewels, nothing that she loved. She dreamed of all luxuries of life, rich dresses, jewels, and a grand palatial mansion with vast rooms and inviting smaller rooms perfumed for chats with close friends. Mathilde had a rich friend, a former schoolmate at the convent. Mathilde avoided visiting her former classmate because their meeting would make her weep with regret, despair, and misery. Despair means to lose all hope. Now, I will ask one question. Try to give answer of this question. Why did Mathilde weep with misery after visiting her schoolmate? Why did Mathilde weep with misery after visiting her schoolmate? Next. Try to give answer of this question. Okay. Mathilde wept with misery after visiting her schoolmate because she couldn't get the riches and the luxurious life in which the schoolmate was relishing. Okay. Next. One evening, her husband came home with an air of triumph, holding a large envelope in his hand. "Look," he said, "here is something for you. Look at this picture." One evening, Mathilda's husband came with an air of victory, holding a large envelope in his hand. Look at this. Holding a large envelope in his hand. He said, "Look, here is something for you." Next. She tore open. She tore open the paper and drew out a card on which was printed the word, "The Minister of Education and Madame Georges Rompono request the pleasure of M. It means Monsieur. And Madame Loisel's company at the ministry on the evening of Monday, January 18th. Mathilde tore open the paper and drew out the card on which was printed the words. The words were printed. Look at these words. Mathilde tore open the paper. "The Minister of Education and Madame Rompono, Georges Rompono, request the pleasure of the company of Monsieur and Madame Loisel at the ministry on the evening of Monday, January 18th. 18th January, day Monday. The evening of Monday. Okay, next. M stands for Monsieur and MME stands for Madame. French terms of address. Like Mr. and Mrs. in English. Monsieur means Mr. and madam means missus in English. Read the phrases. Next, read the phrases. Her husband, the necklace, an error, all these things. Another woman, one evening, her husband. In all these phrases, we see some words used before the nouns. Look at these words. Husband, it is a noun. And her is used before the noun. The necklace. Necklace is noun. And the is used before the noun. Like this, they specify to make it clear what noun we are talking about. These words that are used at the beginning of a noun phrase are known as determiners. Determiners include articles, a, and, the, possessive pronouns, my, our, your, her, etc. Words like this, that, much, many, all, and number. These are determiners. Articles and possessive pronouns include. Next, I will ask one question. Try to give answer of this question. What did the envelope hold? What did the envelope hold? Okay, the envelope held an invitation form. The Minister of Education and Madame Lois's company at the ministry on the evening of Monday, January 18th. The envelope held an invitation. Okay, next. Instead of being delighted, as her husband had hoped, she threw the invitation on the table resentfully and muttered, "What do you want me to do with that? And what do you expect me to wear if I go?" Look at this picture. We saw the invitation was from the Minister of Education and Mathilde threw the invitation. Her husband had hoped she will become happy, but she threw the invitation on the table recently and whispered, "What do you want me to do with that? And what do you expect me here if I go?" Next. He hadn't thought of that. He stammered, "Why, the dress you go to the theater in, it seems very nice to me." Look at this picture. Mr. Loisel, Matilda's husband, it means Mr. Loisel. Mr. Loisel hadn't thought of that. He stammered. Stammered, it means hesitated and repeated sound while talking. He stammered, "Why, the dress you go to the theater in, it seems very nice to me." Next. He stopped, stunned, distressed, to see his wife crying. He stuttered, "What's the matter? Let's see. Mathilde, how much would a suitable dress cost?" Matilda's husband stopped, turned, distressed to see his wife crying. He stuttered, it means stammered. He stammered, look at this picture. He stammered, "What's the matter? Why? What's the matter?" He stopped, he turned to see his wife crying and stammered, "What's the matter? Let's see, Mathilde, how much would a suitable dress cost?" Next. She thought for a moment, computing the cost and also wondering what amount she could ask for without an immediate refusal. At last, she answered hesitantly, "I don't know exactly, but I think I could do it with 400 francs. Look at this picture. Mathilde thought for a while. She calculated and asked Rahim to give her 400 francs to buy a suitable dress. Next. He turned a little pale because he had been saving that exact amount to buy a gun for a hunting summer in the country near Nantre. With a few friends, however, he said, "Very well, I can give you 400 francs, but try and get a really beautiful dress." Look at this picture. Her husband turned a little pale because Mr. Loisel had been saving that exact amount to buy a gun for a hunting summer in the country near Nantes with a few friends. Mathilde's husband sacrificed his own hunting joy and gave his savings to Mathilde, 400 francs. Next. Was the husband a considerate person? How do we know that? Try to give answer of this question. Okay. Yes. Mathilde's husband was a considerate person. He told her to buy a suitable dress, and though he had been saving money to buy himself a gun for a hunting, he gave his wife Mathilde 400 francs to buy a new dress for the occasion. Okay, next. The day of the party drew near, and Madame Loisel seemed sad, restless, anxious, though her dress was ready. One evening, her husband said to her, What's the matter? You have been acting strange the last 3 days. Look at this picture. The day of the party drew near. And Mathilde was sad, restless, and anxious, though her dress was ready, because she had no dress, she had not a single precious stone to wear. Next. Her husband asked her, "What's the matter? You have been acting strange these last 3 days." She replied, "I am upset that I have no jewels, not a single stone to wear. I would rather not go to the party." "You could wear flowers," he said. "They are very fashionable at this time of year." She was not convinced. Look at this picture. Mathilde replied, "I am upset that I have no jewels. Not a single stone to wear." Mathilde was upset because she had no jewels, not a single stone to wear. She would rather not go to the party. That time, her husband said, "You could wear flowers. They are very fashionable at this time of year." But Mathilde was not convinced. Next. I will ask one question. Try to give answer of this question. Why was Mathilde sad, restless, and anxious, though her dress was ready? Try to give answer. Okay. Mathilde was sad, restless, and anxious because though she had a new dress, she did not have any jewels to wear for the party. Next. The next day, she went to her friend's house and told her of her distress. Look at this picture. The next day, Mathilde went to her friend's house and told her of her distress. Madame Forestier was her spring. Next. Madam Forestier went to her mirrored wardrobe, took out a large box, brought it back, opened it, and said to Madame Loiseau, "Choose, my dear. First, Mathilde saw some bracelets, then a pearl necklace. She tried on the jewelry in the mirror. She kept asking, 'We have nothing else?' Mother Forestier went to her mirror wardrobe, took out a large box, brought it back, opened it, and said to Madame Loiseau, 'Choose, my dear. First, Mathilde saw some bracelets, then a pearl necklace. She tried on the jewelry in the mirror. She kept asking, "You have nothing else?" "Why, yes, but I don't know what you like." Look at this picture. Madame Forestier went to her mirrored wardrobe. This is mirrored wardrobe. She took out a large box, brought it back, opened it, and asked Madame Loiseau to choose. First, Mathilda saw some bracelets. Then she saw a pearl necklace. She tried on the jewelry in the mirror. She asked, "You have nothing else?" That time, Forestier replied. Madame Forestier replied, "Why, yes, but I don't know what you like." Next. What did Madame Forestier's large box contain? Try to give answer. Okay. Madame Forestier's large box contained bracelets, necklace, and other jewelry. Okay? Next. Suddenly, she discovered in a black satin box a superb diamond necklace, and her heart began to beat with uncontrolled desire. Her hands trembled as she took it. She fastened it around her neck and stood lost in ecstasy as she looked at herself. Then she asked her anxiously, hesitating, "Would you lend me this?" "Why, yes, of course." She threw her arms around her friend's neck rapturously, then played with her treasure. Rapturously, it means with great joy. And played with her treasure, it means went away quickly. Suddenly, Mathilde discovered in a black satin box a superb diamond necklace. Look at this necklace. A superb diamond necklace. And Mathilde's heart began to beat with uncontrolled desire. Her hands trembled as she took it. She fastened it around her neck and stood lost in it. Ecstasy as she looked at herself. She asked her anxiously, hesitating, "Would you lend me just this?" And Madame Forestier replied, "Why, yes, of course." That time, Mathilde threw her arms around her friend's neck, it means Madame Forestier's neck, and with great joy, she went away quickly. These sentences tell us that Mathilde greatly desired the necklace. Try to give answer of this question. These sentences tell us that Mathilde greatly desired the necklace. Okay. Her heart began to beat with uncontrolled desire. Her hands trembled as she took it. She stood lost in ecstasy as she looked at herself in the mirror. Then she asked anxiously, hesitating, "Would you lend me this?" "Just this." Okay. The day of the party arrived. Madame Loiseau was a success. She was prettier than all the other women, elegant, gracious, smiling, and full of joy. She danced wildly with passion, forgetting everything in the triumph of her beauty and success, floating in a cloud of happiness. Look at this picture. At last, the day of the party arrived. Madame Loiseau looked prettier than all the other women. It is a sentence of comparative degree. She was elegant, gracious. Gracious, it means showing the comfort and easy way of life. She was smiling and full of joy. She danced wildly. Wildly means a way that is not controlled. She danced wildly, forgetting everything in the triumph of her beauty. Next. Mathilda and her husband left at about 4 o'clock in the morning. When they were finally in the street, they could not find a cab. They walked down toward the sink till they found one. They were dropped off at the door in the Rue de Martyrs, and sadly, it was all over for her. In front of the mirror, she took a final look at herself in all her glory. But suddenly, she uttered a cry. She no longer had the necklace round her neck. "What is the matter?" asked her husband. She turned towards him, panic-stricken. I no longer have Madame Forestier's necklace." He stood up. "Distraught. What? How? That's impossible." Mathilda and her husband left at about 4 o'clock in the morning. When they were finally in the street, they could not find a cab. They walked down toward the sea till they found one. They were dropped off at the door in the Rue de Martyrs, and sadly, it was all over for her. In front of the mirror, she took a final look at herself. But suddenly, she uttered a cry. She no longer had the necklace around her neck. Mathilde's husband asked, "What is the matter?" Mathilde turned towards him, panic-stricken. Panic-stricken, it means with a sudden feeling of fear. I no longer have Madame Forestier's necklace." That time, her husband stood up, distraught. Distraught, it means worried, disturbed. "What? How? That's impossible." Here, we have completed our part one of this story. Write new words and their meaning in your classwork notebook. Read again and again. Write in-text questions, it means margin questions, in your classwork notebook. Read again and again. We will learn part second in our next period. Thank you.